I'm Grace from the Turtle Guardians. Today I'm going to show you how to properly move a snapping turtle across the road. We're going to use our trusty friend Maple to help us today. This is a snapping turtle, and snapping turtles need as much help as they can get. Never pick up a snapping turtle by the tail. A snapping turtle's tail is connected to its spine, so you could actually really hurt the turtle and do more damage by picking it up by its tail. Instead, you want to slide your finger underneath the shell and pick it up like a waitress tray. When my hand is underneath the turtle, it cannot snap to bite me. I might get scratched a little bit, but that's a lot better than having this turtle get hit on the road. The other thing that I can do is hold Maple from the back, like this. She also can't bite me this way, as she can bite around, but not that far. I don't want to put my hands anywhere near her face, and I don't want to put my hands near the front of her shell, where she might be able to bite. If you're too scared to pick up a snapping turtle, there's some other things you can do to help them across the road. The worst thing you can do is leave them to get hit by a car. You can wheelbarrow them across the road like this. Come on, Maple. Or backwards like this. You can even put them on a car mat or a shovel or anything you have in your car to help them get across. Never leave a turtle on the road to get hit. That's the last thing you want to do. Now, one thing to be aware of is that when you pick up the turtle, there's a good chance they're going to try to snap at you. And there's a lot of force behind that snap, so you want to be careful. You don't want to drop the turtle and do more damage. So if it's a heavy turtle and you think they're going to try to snap at you, keep them low to the ground so that if you do drop them, it's not going to do damage. One tip from a turtle expert who's picked up a lot of turtles is to be quicker than the turtle. I like to run at them. Most of the time they're on the road, so you want to be quick anyway. Run from behind. They'll never even see you coming. And by the time you get them across the road, they won't even know what's happened. Now, if Maple were any other kind of turtle, I would be able to hold her just like a sandwich, like this. I might get peed on, I might get scratched, but that's the worst any other turtle's gonna do to you. It's very unlikely that they're gonna try to bite you. Snapping turtles only bite because they have a very small undershell called the plastron. You can see that Maple's undershell is small and she can't hide in her shell like other turtles can. And that's why snapping turtles will try to bite you, because they're scared. You look like a big scary giant to them. They're much more scared of you than you are of them. Well, thanks for helping us today, Maple. And thanks for learning about how to help turtles across the road.